My name is Dr. Mozem Tivana, and today we are going to talk about the handover in the 3G WCDMA or 3G UMTS. Now, first of all, we discussed that what is handover. For example, there is a mobile which is connected to the node B number 1, or it is in communication with the base station or node B number 1. But this mobile is moving towards the node B number 2. In that case, the power it is receiving from the node B number 2, for example, it's P2, and the power it is receiving from node B number 1, it is P1. So in that case, with the passage of time, power P2 being received from the node B number 2 would be increasing, while the power being received from node B number 1, which is P1, would be decreasing. So when this difference between these two powers increases a certain threshold, for example, I call it as 6 dBm. So in that case, this means that power of the node B number 2 is 6 dBm higher than the power received from the node B number 1 by this mobile. So this mobile would get connected with the node B number 2. So this procedure is known as the handover. But there can be two types of the handover. First handover is the hard handover. In the hard handover, when there is an handover from this node B to this node B, first this mobile would break its connection with the node B number 1, and then it would be make its connection with node B number 2. So it is a make after the break, or it is also known as the hard handover. But in the other case, when this mobile first connects with the node B number 2, and then after connected with node B number 2, it breaks its connection with node B number 1, then I call it as a soft handover, because it is the make before break type of scenario, because in that case there is a time when this mobile is connected with both of these two node Bs. So this is known as the soft handover or make before break. So the handover in the 3G is soft handover, and the soft handover is preferable because in that case there is no interruption for the service to the mobile, as at a time it is connected to two node Bs. Now we come to the procedure of soft handover, that how soft handover takes place. For example, this is a mobile which is connected to node B number 1, and it is moving towards the node B number 2. This mobile would not only be measuring power of its own BTS, the power received from node B number 1, but also the power received from node B number 2 and the other neighboring node Bs. And this information about the received power would be sent to the radio network controller via node B1, and it would be called as the measurement report. Now, due to this measurement report, the RNC would know as the mobile set is moving from node B number 1 to the node B number 2 that the power of node B number 2 is increasing, and the power of node B number 1 as received by the mobile is decreasing. So when the power of a node B number 2 increases a certain threshold, the RNC instructs the mobile to add node B number 2 in its active set. And for that, it sends the active set update command to the mobile via node B number 1 to add node B number 2 in its active set. This means that now this mobile station would connect to the node B 2. Or in other words, this mobile is in state of soft handover with node B number 2, while it is also connected with node B number 1. So once this mobile station establishes this connection, this mobile station would confirm the RNC about the establishment of this connection through active set update complete message, which would be sent from the mobile to the RNC. Now, once a mobile is connected to two node Bs, in that case, it would be sending the same information or data from this path as well as from this path. So R and C can now choose the information with minimum error, as it is the same information coming from both the paths. Similarly, in the other direction, the information that mobile station would be getting would be from this R and C as well as from this information. So mobile station can combine the two informations as they are the copy of the same information, so that error is the minimum. Now, as this mobile moves from node B number 1 to node B number 2, and for example, it reaches here. So, and as the RNC is monitoring this received power of this mobile through the measurement reports, this RNC may decide that now the node B number 1 should be removed from the active set of this mobile station. So, RNC would send the active set update message to this mobile, instructing it to remove its connection with the node B number 1, or can delete its connection with the node B number 1, and now it would only be connected to the node B number 2. One another thing I want to highlight is that in the active set of a mobile station, there can be maximum 8 node Bs. This means that this mobile station can be in a situation of soft handover with 8 node Bs at a time. Now we come to a type of basically soft handover, which is known as the softer handover. Softer handover is between the sectors of the same cell. For example, this is a cell which is divided into three sectors. This mobile station, antenna covers this sector. This antenna serves this sector, and this antenna serves this sector. So when this mobile moves from this sector to this sector, it can be in the state of soft handover between these two sectors, and the rest of the procedure is the same as we discuss in the soft handover. Now in 3G there are situation when you have hard handover. For example, if this mobile station is connected to node B number 1, but it is moving toward node B number 2, in that case, if the frequency that is used in node B number 1, for example, it's F1, and in node B2 a different frequency F2 is being used, in that case, when this handover takes place, it cannot be soft handover, because for the soft handover we need the same frequency in the two node Bs. But because this frequency is different, we will have the hard handover, because it is interfrequency handover. Another case in which we have hard handover, for example, this is a 3G base station and this is a 2G base station. In that case, when this mobile moves from node B number 1 to node B number 2, the hard handover would be hard handover, because it is inter rat or inter radio access technology handover between 3G and 2G. Similarly, there can be cases, for example, this mobile, it has been allotted a channel, but there are by this node B, but there are many errors in that. In that case, we need to either change its channel in the same cell. In that case, there would be hard handover. Or for example, we want to upgrade the data channel of this mobile station. In that case, we need to reconfigure the channel. So in that case also, due to the physical channel reconfiguration, we would do hard handover.